full diagram of the brain's connectome could also unlock the secret of the self, that essence that makes us so uniquely human.
And this allows us a processing of information that may encompass any aspect by the individual.
Using a new souped-up MRI scanner, Toga tracks the movement of water molecules that flow along the neural fibers. That pathway shows us how neurons are positioned and how they're connected.
There's the top plane and the bottom plane. From these, we can compute a tract and how it courses through the brain.
The connections are color-coded to indicate the direction in which they move.
The bluish color that you see, these fibers may connect either to motor systems or sensory systems, moving information out to affect motor movements or sensory information back up for processing.
The color coding illustrates how any given thought can pass through multiple parts of the brain, darting from neuron to neuron to make abstract connections.
When you embark upon such a monumental task to study an organ system that's capable of performing a Beethoven concerto, or ballet, or running the 100-meter dash, those are feats of humanness that just gives you awe-inspiring willingness to keep trying to map it.
Every one of the brain's billions of neurons has its own complex wiring diagram. Locked inside our skulls are miles of connections between each of those neurons. And with every memory, every new experience, those connections change.
We used to think that the brain was pretty much set after childhood, but now we know differently. The brain continues to learn and change all the time. This quality called plasticity, when we have new experiences, especially if they're intense or we repeat them a lot, we can burn new pathways. We can also forget old ones.
It is a tremendous opportunity to understand our humanness, if you will. Developing a complete map of the connectome is part of that quest.
Some people say that the connectome is us. Our memories, our dreams, our hopes, our defeats, all of that encoded in our connectome.
One thing that's fascinating about the connectome is if you could really go in and take a scan and then have that brain turn into software, or you could have the analog world version of you and the digital world equivalent of you.
So what happens when the soul is digitized, put on a silicone chip, and made available for download?
I mean, I think one of the big questions is if we could develop conscious, intelligent robots, would they be human? How would that make us feel about our humanity?